We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
As you can see over here, I have already downloaded the control called ODT for Visual Studio 2015, right? Now I am installing it. As you can see over here, I should be able, without this component, I should be able to access Oracle data in my Visual Studio, but I cannot use it in my application, right? So for that, what I have to do, as you can see over here, I am not able to import system.data.oracle, right? So for that reason, I have to install this tool, Oracle Developer Tool for Visual Studio 2015, right? I am installing it. As you can see, it is being installed in my system. So now, as you can see, we have successfully installed Oracle Developer Tool for Visual Studio 2015, right? Now let us see whether we can access it from the Visual Studio or not. So now we have created the GUI as displayed over here. Now we have installed the Oracle data provider for Visual Studio 2015. Now let's try to access the Oracle database. For that, you need to right click on data connection in Server Explorer, add connection. Now you can see the dialog box has been changed. Okay, and you can see the data source name is Oracle Database ODT.net, which is what we have just installed. Now it provides you different kind of authentication, but we are going to use the authentication which is being used in Oracle, right? So at the time of installation, we have provided the name system. My password is also system. Now you can tick mark over here so that for each and every transaction it won't ask you again and again. Now the connection type will be of EasyNet. Over here you can see the database host name. Now to retrieve this detail, you need to execute a command in command prompt, and that is what listener control status. Once you execute the command, it will show you the detail of Oracle services running on your system. As you can see, what are the details we required over here? The database host name, as my Oracle is running on localhost, right? So over here, either I can provide the name as localhost, or you can specify the IP address or the computer name where your Oracle database has been installed, right? The next detail is the port number. Over here, you can see it shows me two different ports. One port number is 1521 and second one is 8081. But 8081 is for presentation HTTP session, which is what through which we can access the Oracle, or you can say we can manage the Oracle database from the browser, right? You can see over here 8080. It is not at all required to us in a programming. So obviously we require this 1521 port over here. So I will write down 1521. Now the database service name, that is also available over here. Default service XE. So I need to write down over here XE. Fine. Now let us check the connection. Yes, the connection has been succeeded. Then press OK. Now you can see, you can access all the tables of your Oracle database over here. Just now, I've already created a table called student. So let's check it out whether I can access it. Yes, I can access it from the Visual Studio. You can create new table also from here. Just right click on new relational table. Now you can see a new table dialog box has been opened. You can provide the name of the column, data type of the column, precision scale means size of this column. Then you can specify the name of the table. You can specify constraint over here. You can specify index over here. Everything you can do from the SQL command prompt or SQL browser, you can do the same thing from the Visual Studio with the help of what? This new data connection. But mind it, for doing all these things, you need to install that ODT provider for Oracle that you need to download from the website of Oracle, right? Okay. Now, I have already created a table called student, so I am not going to create it again. I simply close it. Now, as you know, if we want to access the Microsoft SQL database, we are going to import a class called imports System.data.sql client, but we are going to access Oracle is not at all available over here. Now to access the Oracle client, we need to add one reference that we can do from here. Add references, go to extension and find out the Oracle managed data access. This is being installed when we have installed ODT provider for Oracle, right? So this will help me out to connect with my database, Oracle database, right? So click OK. Now you can see I can imports System.data.oracle.managedDataAccess.client. Now it will help me out to connect with the Oracle database. Now to access, or you can say to make the connection with the Oracle database, we require few connection object and command objects that we are going to create inside the class, that is BIM CN for the connection as Oracle connection. BIM CMD as Oracle command. BIM DT as, we are just declaring the variable, we are not initializing it. BIM DT as data table. Okay, so we have added three objects. We have declared three objects, one for Oracle connection, one for Oracle command, and one for data table. Few more objects are required, that is DIM, DA as Oracle data adapter. okay, connection command table and adapter. Now we are going to declare few user defined procedures through which we can get the data. See, I'm basically going to create three user defined methods. One method is load data, which initially loads the data as soon as the form gets loaded, right? So private sub, obviously it should be a sub procedure, load data, private sub load data. Now as soon as my form gets loaded, what is required? We need to create a database connection to our application. So for that I'm going to initialize my connection object, that is CN is equals to new Oracle connection. See what it is asking. We can provide three different types of parameter: blank, connection string and credential. So I'm going to use this second one. Okay, so for that we require a connection string. Now from where I can get the connection string? We have recently connected with the Oracle database. You can right click on the Oracle instance in the Server Explorer, right click there, properties, you can find the connection string over here. Just copy and paste it and put it inside this constructor. Okay, that's it. Now we need to open the connection, because this is the only way to transmit our query or to send our query to the Oracle database, right? So as soon as my form gets loaded, I need to establish a connection between my application and Oracle database. So that is what I have done by writing these two statements. Now I am calling the load data method. So what load data method will do? See, I have taken one instance of a data grid control. What should happen? As soon as my form gets loaded, the data available in the student table needs to be displayed over here so that I can come to know that this is the current data available in my student table, right? As soon as I click on new table, it will insert record into student table. As soon as I update, it will update it. As soon as I delete button, it will delete from the table. Okay, so now what we want to do, we want to display the data in this data grid view. So what is the name of this data grid view control? Data grid view 1. Fine. So data grid view one dot data source is equals to get data. See, this is the user defined method, it is not predefined method. Get data. Now in this method, what it will do? It will trigger a select query on my Oracle database, retrieve the data and send those data to the data grid view control, right? So what I have to write down over here? Select star from student. Fine. So what I have to do? I have to create a user defined function. Obviously over here I need to create a function because it returns something, right? So private function get data. Now what type of parameter we require? Over here you can see we require string kind of parameter. Okay, so I have to write down string query. Now what it will return, that I have to write down over here. So it will return data table. Okay, as data table. Fine. Now, as you can see, it returns me a warning because we have not returned anything. So, here we are going to instantiate this data table because it is what we are going to return. DP is equals to new data table. Okay, we have instantiated the data table object. Now it's time to execute this query. Okay, for that we require data adapter object. DA, because data adapter is a bridge between database and application. DA is equals to new Oracle data adapter. Now you can see it can be specified in four different ways. Right, so I am going to use the second one because we have both the things query over here as well as the connection instance, which is what we have created in form load event, and we have declared them locally so that I can access the instance throughout the form. Okay, so over here what I have to do, first of all I have to pass the query which is available in query variable. Sorry. Query and the connection instance which is available in CA. Right, now DA data adapter is having a field method which executes the query using the data adapter object and retrieve the data by using the field method and load it into corresponding data table or data set object DA dot fill, in which I need to pass DP. Okay, so now my data is available over here, and which is what we need to pass return DT. Fine. Okay, let's save it. Now let us check it out whether I can get the data over here. Sorry, we'll execute the another form. Okay, now let us execute the code. As you can see, it is showing me one error. Now, you will surprise that why I'm getting this error. We are getting this error because in connection string, password parameter is not available, which you need to mention. But over here, we have copied the password string, right? Password is a confidential data and which is not going to be displayed in a connection string in a plain text form. So what we need to do, we need to type it manually. Okay, so I'm stop the execution of my code. I'm adding it in my connection string. You can see I have added this string, password is equals to my password of Oracle database. Now let us check it out whether I can execute the data. Yes, I can see the table in the data grid view controller, but it contains nothing because we have not yet added any controls. Now as soon as I click on new button, it should be added into this data grid view, right? It should be added into the student table as well as this data grid view. So let's do that. For that we need to create one more method called put data, because for performing insert, update and delete operation I am going to create a common method called put data method, which returns actually nothing. So it should be a procedure, private sub put data. Again, in this method, I have to pass what? Query as string, right? In which we are going to initialize command object. CMD is equals to new Oracle command. So you can see, you can set it by three ways. I am going to set it with this one, the third parameter, that is query as well as connection. The same thing we have done in case of data adapter. So it should be query comma cn, right? And then cmd dot execute non query. That's it. We have done. The data has been inserted into the database, Oracle database. But before that, we need to load our data grid also. So for that, I need to call this method. So after execution of this statement, I will call load data. Let's save it. Start the execution. Let's say fields are missing: name, address, enrollment number, and branch. Okay, so now you can see I have modified my student table according to my fields available on the form. And one more thing I have updated over here, I have taken one combo box in which I have loaded few branch, right? That I have done with the help of this two statements. I have created an array of branch, I have added that array to that branch combo box. Okay, so this two statement will load my combo box in the form loading room. Now when my data gets loaded into the student table, as soon as I click on new button, so I need to click on new button. This is the button, click event. Now from this event I need to call my put data method. Let's say put data, then what I have to pass, see, it is showing you what type of parameter you need to pass. We need to pass a query, so we must know the insert query. Insert into student values. Okay, what are the values from where I can get the data? I can get the data from these fields. Fine, let me change the color of this form so that it can be visible to everybody clearly. So background color, yes, this. I need to change it to blue. Now it is quite visible. Now, what is the name of this control? As you can see, txt name, txt address, txt er number, and cmd branch. So when I click on new button, the data should be get from this controls. So first of all, we have all the fields in my student table as varchar. So you know varchar data can be passed like this. We have four attributes. Now fine, now let us see the field sequence. The first one is the name, because I'm using the specified insert query, right? Name, address, enrollment number, and branch. These are the four branches, right? The data for which I need to pass over here. So what I will do, the first one is the name, and that I can get from the name table. For that, I need to append my existing query, modify my existing query. So how I can modify? Like this. So it won't give you any kind of error. Text, yes, name dot text. Okay, the second one is address, again double ampersand, in between I need to pass my parameter, that is text address dot text. Fine, again double ampersand, txt enrollment number dot text. Okay, and the last one is combo box, double ampersand, cmb branch dot text. Fine, so it will execute my query, right? As soon as this query, this put data method will be called, it will go to this procedure, right? This procedure will execute the specified query, right? Load the data, and at the same time it will return me a message, msg box data inserted. Let's check it out whether it is working or not, but before that I need to save it. Fine. Ramesh. Computer. Let's check it out. As you can see, data has been inserted. It is available in the table. Fine. Now let us see whether it is available in our Oracle. It can be visible to me in Oracle or not. Where is my Oracle? Yes, Oracle 11G. Yes, you can see Ramesh is available in my Oracle. Fine. Okay. Similarly, we can implement the update and delete. But before that, while performing update and delete, you need to make sure that one key must be there in our table so that I can identify the record with the help of that key. So over here, we are going to use this enrollment number as a primary key, though I have not specified it. But whenever we are preparing a professional VB.NET application, at that time we need to make sure that each and every database table must have at least one primary key. Okay, so let's perform the remaining two operations. That is update. Again, our task is now quite easy. Just we need to call the putData method. PutData. This is the update button. Fine. So I must know the update query. Update. Student. Set. Update student set. What are the fields we are going to modify? Name, address and branch, because enrollment number is a primary key, so we cannot modify that key. Okay, so set name comma address comma branch where ER underscore number is equal to this. This is what we had done in case of insert. The same thing we are going to do over here. So name, from where I can get the name? Again, double inverted comma, double ampersand, txt name dot text. Okay, same way, address, double inverted, double ampersand, txt underscore address dot text. Same way for branch, double inverted, double ampersand, txt, sorry, it's a branch, so it will be cmb branch dot text, where enrollment number, double inverted, double ampersand, txt, er number dot. Okay, got it. Now we have written the update query, but before that, which data will get modified? As soon as I click on the record in data grid view control, those records needs to be filled in my corresponding fields on the form, right? So for that, what I have to do, I have to put something over here. Let's say txt name dot text is equals to data grid view 1 dot rows into bracket e dot row index comma sorry e dot row index dot cells. Which cell? See, it is our first column. right? Name is our first column, so it will be 0 dot value. Fine. The same way we need to write it down for each and every column, right? Okay. So this will be 1, 2, and 3. The second one will be for txt name address. txt enrollment number and cmb branch. Fine. Let's check it out whether it is working or not. Okay. Now let us insert a new record. As you can see, it has been inserted. Now, when I click on record of Ramesh, it should be loaded over here. Yes. Now, it is being loaded, right? Now, as soon as I click on update button, or you can say the delete button, it should update or delete this particular record from the database. Okay? So, we have already returned the data query. Just we need to send a message. Let's say data updated. Fine. Let us save it. Let's save the record. Let me change the address of this user instead of Barush. Now, sorry. Okay. Now you can see the address of Moyes has been changed. Is it clear? Similarly, you can perform the delete operation too. Fine. For performing delete operation, what I have to do? Again, I need to write down the same type of query. Just it's a matter of changing the query. Delete from student where enrollment number is equals to the enrollment number available in the text box. Data deleted. Fine. Let's check it out. Shanak Baruch 1966020019001. Now the record has been inserted. Now let us delete the record of Mahesh. As you can see, the record of Mahesh has been deleted, but the text boxes are not cleared. So for that, you can write down the clear method. Fine. So this is what all we have seen today for insert, update, delete, and fetch data. Thanks for watching.